What was the best thing the quiet kid has said or done in class? Once it was right before winter break, and just as the bell was about to ring to end class, our teacher cut in with, "Oh, I forgot, you have homework over the break." Everyone groaned, and even the quiet kid in the corner let out an "what an asshole." Well, teacher heard it, and said, "What did you say?" to the kid. To his credit, he put his head up and loudly said, "What an ass." Harlowell stated, cracking up, and the teacher's face turned so red. I caught up with the kid after the break and his excuse was the teacher already heard it anyway. I wasn't going to get away with it, so since he asked I answered. Apostrophe. There was a guy named Phil in my high school psychology class who had pretty severe Asperger's. People were often mean to him because high school, but I genuinely liked him. And while he was very quiet, when he did speak, I thought he was hilarious. One day my teacher was jokingly giving me shit about protecting my sensitive information. I yelled out my social security number extremely quickly, almost in gibberish. Phil repeated it back verbatim, and told me he was going to steal my identity. Then he put his cape on, and ran out of the classroom. I hope Phil is doing well these days, he was awesome. I was best friends with the quiet kid in high school. He spoke to me almost exclusively, and quietly enough that others rarely noticed. One day, the loud girl noticed. "Oh my god, he talks. I haven't heard you talk since 6th grade." Without looking at her, he leans in real close, and whispers something to me. He says he only talks to interesting PR people. You'll always remember this, partly for the ego boost he gave me, but also because of her reaction. Screw you. I hope I don't hear you for another 4 years. Korean kid in Canada, socially awkward, didn't speak English very well, physically not coordinated playing any sport, even running. That was until we were on a field trip, and at lunch we went to a place with Dance Dance Revolution. It was like the videos, playing on both pads, hands on railings, blasting the game to oblivion, setting high scores only to beat them. He had the entire leaderboard before we left. First time I saw him smile. One of the most impressive things I have ever seen. My friend decided he hated the quiet kid. He wasn't super quiet, but he didn't have any friends. One day my friend kept throwing those tiny Chips Ahoy cookies at the back of the quiet kid's head, who was sitting by himself at lunch. Quiet kid picked up one of the cookies, stood over my sitting friend, and smashed the sheet out of that cookie on my friend's head. It was amazing. Edit, for those asking if we are still friends, or why I was friends with someone like that. It was the first time my friend was being this way. It was off-putting to several people, and no, we aren't really friends anymore. Scene, biology. Teacher, now even though clones are the same genetically, they may come out differently. If we clone James here, his clone might have more access to quiet kid friends. Teacher doesn't even argue, and just looks sadly at the kid. Not as extreme as others, but still completely unexpected. Not in school, but I teach middle to high school kids, 13 to 17, how to umpire baseball games. There was one kid, 13 years old, who was very quiet, reserved and shy, and I thought, this is not the vocation for him. A week later I swing by the field to evaluate him, and see if I can help him with anything. I arrived about 5 minutes after the game started, and I could hear loud, confident and definitive calls coming from this kid. I was floored. His mom came up to me, and said that becoming an umpire has completely changed his personality. 6th grade science class, teacher was out of the room and we were ducking around with hot plates. While messing around, one of my classmates burns his hand pretty bad on a hot plate, and has to go to the nurse. Right after he leaves the room, quiet kid enters, and casually says, "Smells like burnt flesh in here," and just sits down, like it was nothing. Everyone turned and just stared at him. 7th grade, new kid named Nick started school halfway through the year. He sat next to me in English class, and didn't say anything ever. One day, we were reading poems out loud and critiquing each other. One sorry fella read his, and every line started with, "If I was a bird, if I was a bird, I'd live in a tree. If I was a bird, I'd fly to school. If I was a bird." A few people offered polite criticism. The teacher called on Nick for his opinion, and he said, "If I was a bird, I'd poop on all of you." He got kicked out of class, and I still laugh every time I think about it. We became friends, and he was actually a pretty nice guy. I think he just couldn't resist making that joke. There was a girl who went the entirety of middle school never speaking a word unless absolutely necessary. One day the class was being rowdy, while the teacher was out of the room, and in the raspiest, deepest voice ever yelled, "Shut up." We all shut up. I remember going to junior high in this small hick town in Texas, while I was on probation. That's a long story. Had a quiet kid who was actually really popular, not bullied at all like most quiet kids. Anyway, I was new. Had only been going to the school for about a month when this happened. We had a substitute teacher for one of our classes. She was doing a quick roll call, and got to his name. Pyagius. She said, "That's an interesting and beautiful name. What does it mean?" He said, "Lice." There was dead silence, and confused looks all around. This kid had been going to this school since kindergarten, small town, and had always gone by Pyagius, which was his nickname. Nobody had a ducking clue what it meant, let alone that it was his real name. All of his paperwork at the school had to be updated and everything. I thought it was hilarious. Beat the sheet out of the kid that kept pocking, touching, slapping at him. I think it was around the seventh time he said, "Dude, please stop," before the blood came. There was a fly in the room. He threw his pencil straight up, and ducking skewered the fly, and the pencil got stuck in the ceiling. It was those really weak plaster tile things, but it was the coolest thing I've ever seen. I wish I could go back in time and record it. This one kid in high school said he wanted to go to Harvard, and this quiet dude in the back of the class said, "Harvard? No. Stuart's maybe. Stuart's is a local cosmetology school." Whole class lost it. Classmates used to throw crumpled paper balls at her every day because they knew she wouldn't react. One day she started picking them up, spitting on them, and throwing them back. The teacher just smiled and watched. Edited to add context, the teacher was no nonsense and regularly yelled at and gave detention to those sheet kiker kids. But, being sheet kikers, none of that ever stopped them. So when quiet girl decided to step up, he just let her do her thing. Right square bracket. One girl screamed, "I just wanted to duck randomly in class. Sell drugs." He was the typical quiet good kid who always made good grades. He was also the best drug dealer at our school. Since all the teachers saw him as this innocent angel, he never once got caught. My friend was the quiet kid. In high school drafting class, back when drafting was done on paper, there was another kid harassing him from across the room. He took his T-square, about 2 feet long, made of wood, sharp edges, and whipped it across the room, hitting his harasser square on the side of the head. The resulting head wound required several stitches. When I was a kid, I was obsessed with The Simpsons, and one day I kept narrating everything in the Duffman voice. Duffman says, "Oh yeah, etc." Eventually the quiet kid next to me stood up and screamed, "Shut the duck up. I don't give a duck what the Duffman says." He got in trouble and I didn't, cause the teacher hadn't heard any of my Duffman quotes. I still think about him sometimes. "I'm sorry, man, I was being so annoying, and you didn't deserve to get in trouble." My wife told me of a really, really quiet kid in her class. No one ever heard him speak, because he has some sort of mental thing and the teacher knew not to call on him. The last week of school this kid finally speaks. 100% British. This is in the cornfields of the Midwest. Edit. Thanks for the gold. P.S. I don't think British people have mental thing. Lol. I was in a marketing class once, and the instructor put up a slide with advertisements for Axe body spray. He asked the class, "What do you think this product is for?" And the quiet guy piped up and said, "Birth control." We're in health class, on the topic of domestic abuse. Somehow the subject turns to how Britney Spears received backlash for abusing her kids. Kid in the back says, "Probably because she hit her baby one more time." We had a kid at our high school who refused to speak for the entirety of our high school career, even if a teacher called on him. The day we graduated, he spoke for the first time. His reasoning for his 4 years of silence was, "Just because I could." Apostrophe. He took a frozen pizza out of his bag and threw it at a window, shattering it. My sister told me about a quiet guy that asked to go to the bathroom, but the teacher refused, and so just stood up and pissed himself in class. quiet kid in my theater class, they're for the crew type jobs. Our teacher asks us questions daily, and the day's question was, what's your favorite Easter candy, or normal candy, if you don't celebrate? One kid said chocolate bunnies, and the teacher asked what they liked it filled with. Kids chimed in with stuff like peanut butter or marshmallow cream. But this girl just says organs, in the most monotone voice imaginable. A little short blonde girl with a really high-pitched voice read a poem she wrote about how death is inescapable and everyone will die. Geometry teacher was bragging about how well he drew circles, and going on about how one day he would draw a perfect circle. He asked us what would happen if he drew a perfect circle. My friend, a sweet, quiet girl, says rather loudly, "You die." Can't really remember the reaction of the class, but I laughed, and the teacher looked totally crushed. Some pudgy girl was insulting a quiet kid at lunch, and said he was a trash can, because all his ideas were garbage. He told her she must be a refrigerator, because she seems like where all the food goes. Not a crazy thing, but bit of Mad Lad moment edit. Thanks for all the attention. I'm glad everyone enjoyed the story. I'm new to Reddit and thanks to you guys, can post in many more edits now, but I won't forget you all. Thank you. In the last semester of senior year, we were assigned a pass-fail essay. If we made any grammatical, stylistic, or formatting mistake, we would fail. It was traditional for the seniors of each year to write and bomb said essay, and the teachers would never stop gloating about how impossible it was. The quiet kid in my class wrote a perfect essay. Smart, nerdy, quiet kid in the front of class always answered questions correctly when called on. One day the teacher calls on him, and before he even answers, the teacher just lazily says correct and turns back around to write on the board. The second the teacher turns around, the quiet kid just rockets his pencil upward into the ceiling like an arrow. The teacher doesn't notice. It was just such a sudden, unexpected act of rebellion from the quiet kid that never said anything. The whole class saw it, and by the time the teacher turned around, the quiet kid was playing it cool as ice and taking notes again. The teacher doesn't notice. Finally, the teacher turns around again to ask another question, and the entire class is trying not to laugh and everyone is trying not to look at the pencil stuck into the ceiling. The teacher still doesn't notice. A couple of people laugh, and every time the teacher asks what is so funny, the situation became even more hilarious. Finally, the teacher turns around again and continues the lesson, completely oblivious. It was boring math class, and it was the funniest thing that happened all year. Not in class, but I once had a coworker who was quiet and adorable, and generally kept to herself. She overheard me call another coworker a twat waffle, to which she responded, "Twat waffles. Sounds delicious." Professor was talking about the personalities of different cities, and says something like, "Some cities have a lot of personality and talk a lot, some cities whisper, and some cities don't seem to be saying anything at all." At which point this quiet kid who had never uttered a word says, almost under his breath, "Topeka." That was all. Kid had some feelings about Topeka, Kansas. We were having a class discussion or game or something, and needed to come up with hypothetical situations for some reason. This was 2013, so the band One Direction was extremely popular with some, and hated by the others. Teacher, name a place you'd never find One Direction. Class gets quiet for a split second. The same moment quiet kid murmurs Grammys. It was almost too perfect, made more perfect by the fact that it was obviously just supposed to be to himself. What a legend. One kid would be able to have super quiet phone conversations with his mom during class. Everyone right next to him would know he was on the phone, but the teacher and the rest of the class had no idea. Granted, these weren't long convos, but they were still hilarious to witness. Sorry if this is anticlimactic. It was something that was a lot better if you went through it. Haha. There was a quiet kid in my class and he always got up 5 minutes before class ended every day, like to the exact second. One day he got up 20 minutes before class, and I shit you not, the whole class gasped. When the teacher asked him where he was going, he responded, "I need to go check my blood sugar a little earlier today, because I'm going home early to visit Disney." Kid was so quiet, no one even knew he was diabetic. He didn't mention it ever. Lol. Mean girl told quiet friend she was going to beat her up in the parking lot the next morning. Half jokingly I said grab that bitch by the hair and feed her some uppercuts. Next morning I pull in, and lo and behold she's got the half conscious mean girl by the hair, and is absolutely destroying her. Realized I never told her when to stop, and jumped out of the car, and broke it up. Quiet kid was in my friendship group at school and even then, I don't think I ever heard him speak. Nice guy still, somehow, I think. Despite his total not speaking, there are two things he did that stand out, that I remember about him to this day. Firstly, one day, he just straight up fainted in a science class. Doesn't appear to have been anything in said class that would have triggered it. Unfortunately our labs had those high stools, so it was quite a way. The second thing was at a lunchtime. We were at our usual spot by the benches, doing whatever we always did, and at some point we realize he's holding a handful of screws and nuts. After a minute we realized he'd taken all the screws and nuts out of one of the picnic benches, but it was still totally intact. We have zero idea why, but it was outstanding work, especially as we didn't know he was doing it, until he did it. Laughing, but realizing we would get our asses handed to us, if anyone found out, we tried to figure out next steps. So of course some idiot leans on the bench, instantly flatpicking it in one fluid motion, just as the caretaker walks past.